a man, a plan, a canal, Panama. The Panama Canal is one of the most remarkable engineering feats in human history, serving as a vital maritime shortcut that connects the Atlantic Ocean and the Pacific Ocean. Stretching across the narrow isthmus of Panama, it revolutionized global trade and significantly altered the geopolitical landscape of the 20th century. The idea of constructing a canal across the isthmus of Panama dates back to the early 16th century, when the Spanish explorer Vasco Núñez de Balboa first recognized the potential for a waterway connecting the Atlantic and Pacific Oceans. However, it wasn't until the 19th century that the concept gained serious traction, driven by the growing need for faster and more efficient maritime routes. In the 1800s, European powers and the United States were both keenly interested in constructing a canal to facilitate trade between the coasts of the Americas. The French, led by Ferdinand de Lesseps, who had overseen the construction of the Suez Canal, began work on the Panama Canal in the 1880s. However, their efforts were hampered by technical challenges, diseases such as malaria and yellow fever, and financial difficulties. In more than a decade of failed attempts, the French abandoned the project in 1889. In the early 1900s, the United States saw the strategic importance of controlling the isthmus and began negotiating with Colombia, which controlled the area at the time, to secure the rights to build the canal. However, tensions arose between the US and Colombia, leading to the US supporting a revolution in Panama in 1903. With the success of the Panamanian Revolution, Panama became a republic and signed a treaty with the US granting control of the canal zone to the United States. The US then took up the monumental task of completing the canal. The project, now under the direction of the US engineer John Frank Stevens and later George Washington Goethals, faced many challenges, including the need to combat tropical diseases, stabilize the region, and construct massive infrastructure in a difficult environment. The key to the canal's construction was the implementation of a lock-based system, which allowed ships to be lifted over the continental divide and down into the lower sections of the canal. This system required the construction of massive dams, including the Gatun Dam, which created a large artificial lake to provide water for the locks. The efforts of the US engineers, combined with improved public health measures, including the elimination of mosquitoes that spread diseases, helped make the canal's completion possible. After more than a decade of intense labor, the Panama Canal was officially completed on August 15, 1914. And it immediately became a vital link in international trade, allowing ships to bypass the long and treacherous route around the southern tip of South America. Upon completion, the Panama Canal drastically reduced the time and cost of shipping goods between the Atlantic and Pacific. The canal cut the distance between New York and San Francisco by over 8,000 miles, revolutionizing trade between the United States and its western territories, as well as between Europe, the Americas, and Asia. Its strategic importance was immediately evident, and it became an essential part of global trade routes. The Panama Canal also had significant geopolitical implications. Its control by the United States solidified American influence in the Western Hemisphere. During the 20th century, the US maintained its control over the canal, which played a crucial role in both World War I and World War II, facilitating the rapid movement of naval and commercial vessels between oceans. In the latter half of the 20th century, however, the canal became a source of tension between the United States and Panama. The Panamanian government, under the leadership of General Omar Torrijos, pushed for the return of the canal to Panama. In 1977, the Torrijos-Carter Treaty was signed, leading to an agreement in which the US would gradually transfer control of the canal to Panama. This process was completed on December 31, 1999, when Panama officially took over operation and maintenance of the canal. Today, the Panama Canal remains a vital part of global trade. It handles a significant portion of world trade particularly for goods such as oil, grains, and consumer products. Over the years, the canal has undergone major upgrades to accommodate larger ships, including the expansion of the canal's locks, through the construction of the third set of locks, which opened in 2016. This expansion allows the passage of new Panamax vessels, which are significantly larger than the original ships the canal was designed for. The Panama Canal's modern role in global trade highlights its continued relevance. It enables faster, more efficient shipping between key global markets, and its strategic location ensures that it remains a cornerstone of international maritime commerce. The Panama Canal stands as a symbol of human ingenuity and perseverance. From its early conception to its construction and eventual handover to Panama, the canal has shaped global trade and politics for over a century. Today, it remains an essential piece of global infrastructure, continuing to facilitate the movement of goods and connecting the world's oceans. The canal's enduring legacy serves as a reminder of the transformative power of engineering and international cooperation.